So in this video, we will learn about the stereographic projections of structural attributes. So the structural projection, the stereographic projection of structural elements is done on the lower hemisphere, or also known as the southern hemisphere. That means when a plane intersects the outer lining of the southern hemisphere, then the intersection makes a curvature. This curvature, when joined to a specific point, that will give us a curved line that will represent the inclination of this plane. And this intersection, or this projection of the intersection of plane and the sphere, will be obtained on a plane that passes through the equator and through the center of the sphere. And this projection is obtained on the Schmidt net or equal area net. So that point to which this intersection points will be projected is known as zenith. Where the zenith is present? The zenith is present at the topmost of the, if this hemisphere was a part of a sphere, then the topmost part that lies directly above the center, which is perpendicular to this equatorial plane, this point is known as zenith. So when this plane is inserted into this southern hemisphere, the outer lining of this hemisphere will intersect with this plane, and this plane will make a curved line on the intersection. And this intersection, when joined to the zenith, every point on this intersection when joined to the zenith will give a projection on the blue line. This blue line, you can see, this is the projection that is lying on the horizontal plane that is passing through the equatorial plane of this hemisphere. So we will see this, how it works, through an 3D animation. Now you see, this is a sphere, and we need to remove the top of the sphere to make it a hemisphere. We now need only this part of the sphere, that is the southern part of the sphere, that is known as the southern hemisphere. Now, when we insert, this is our plane. When we insert this plane into this sphere, we can see this is a vertical plane. This is clearly visible that this is a vertical plane. And when we see from the top, it makes a straight line. If we see, this will be the equatorial region, and when we pass a plane through this, this will make a straight line on that. The intersection will make a straight line on that horizontal plane. Let's incline this plane to a certain degree. Inclining this plane to a certain degree will give us a projection that is, you need to remember that plane should always pass through the center of the hemisphere. So we can see, after inclining this, this makes a curvature that is result of the intersection between this plane and the hemisphere. Now when we join these points to the zenith, each point to the zenith, that they will make a curvature like this. They will make a curvature that lies on the horizontal plane, that is on the Schmidt net. Now you see here, this is the intersection line, that is curvature of this plane and the hemisphere. If we draw, suppose this is the zenith point. If we draw these lines that are connecting this point, that are connecting the curvature and the zenith point, we will see this, we will trace these lines as a curvature that lies on this plane that passes through the equatorial region of the hemisphere. So this will be the projection of this plane on the Schmidt net. This will be the Schmidt net or equilibrium net. This is the Schmidt net. I hope you can relate both these images. And this is the zenith. Zenith. You can see when we make this plane almost horizontal, that means we make it completely. We will see what kind of projection it makes. See, here the total plane is intersecting the periphery of this hemisphere. That means it is lying totally on the boundary. That means when we see any projection that is lying on the periphery of the Schmidt net, we can assume that, we can determine that this plane is a horizontal one. And likewise, when we see a total straight line on a Schmidt net, we can make out that this is a vertical plane, and anything that lies around it, in between the periphery and the vertical one, is having some angle. Any plane that is nearly horizontal will have a more curvature. So these projection on the Schmidt net are called great circles. The great circle that is near to the periphery, you can see here, the great circle that is near to the periphery is indication that how much closer it is to being horizontal.